2, 1.
Good day, everybody. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal, Professor, Department Chair. We have the eyeball, exenterated eyeball in front of us, and I am going to, in real time, dissect out every layer of the eyeball as we can see, starting from the conjunctiva through the cornea to the lens, and mention a few salient points about each of them. So let's start off with the layer that we see in front of us, that is the conjunctiva. We can see that this is the conjunctiva which is slightly edematous, and this condition is known as conjunctival chemosis. This is the superior fornix of the conjunctiva. This is the inferior fornix of the conjunctiva. This is where tear collects and then it drains. When the tear drains, we can see a curved fold of the conjunctiva. This is known as the plica semilunaris. And we can see a small conjunctival elevation near the medial canthus of the eye. This is known as lacrimal caruncle. Tears temporarily collect in this triangular space on the medial canthus of the eye. And this triangular space is called the lacus lacrimalia, or the lacrimal lake. And after that, it drains away. So having mentioned that, I'm going to lift up the conjunctiva and slice it open. Incidentally, this procedure which I'm going to do right now, this is the very first step, lifting up a conjunctival flap, which is done in cataract surgery. So let's go ahead. I've made a slice of the conjunctiva, and I've lifted up a flap of conjunctiva. What you see in front of you is the flap of conjunctiva. Incidentally, this space under the conjunctiva and the scleroda, this is called the subconjunctival space. And this is a place where we have what is a very common condition known as subconjunctival hemorrhage. If there's a blunt trauma to the orbit, blood may collect and it forms a flame-shaped hemorrhage with the apex of the flame towards the cornea, and the base of the flame is usually not visible because it is headed under the orbit, and that is known as a subconjunctival hemorrhage, which is not a very uncommon condition. So this is a picture to show you subconjunctival hemorrhage. Another most common condition of the conjunctiva, which all of you are familiar with, is conjunctivitis, where the conjunctiva gets inflamed, usually due to a viral infection, and it becomes red and hyperemic. That is conjunctival inflammation, also known as conjunctivitis. This is another picture of conjunctivitis to show conjunctival inflammation and hyperemia. And this is an enlarged view of the previous picture. You can see the hyperemic blood vessels very clearly. Now I'm slicing the conjunctiva and I'm removing it from the surface. You can see. This is the subconjunctival space under the conjunctiva. And I'm slicing the conjunctiva away from the underlying sclera. I'll keep talking in between. Now we can see the subconjunctival space much more clearly. And my instrument has gone under the subconjunctival space. And I'm slicing it. I'm slicing it at the corneoscleral junction. Now I'm slicing the conjunctiva from the superior aspect. In a living specimen, we will see small blood vessels in this region where my instrument is located. But here, because there's a cadaver, we cannot see anything because they've all been exsanguinated. I'm still slicing open the conjunctiva and my instrument is traveling in the subconjunctival space, that is between the conjunctiva and the sclera. One condition which involves the conjunctiva is called pingacula, where there is a nodular swelling on the conjunctiva.
This is a picture of a pingacula on the nasal conjunctiva of a patient.
And yet another condition that is called pterygium, where there is a vascularized growth on the conjunctiva extending from one eye margin towards the corneoscleral junction. The exact cause is not known.
This is a diagrammatic representation of a pterygium on the nasal conjunctiva.
Now I'm again slicing the conjunctiva from the inferior aspect and on the temporal aspect. The last bit of the conjunctiva is left, which I'm going to remove. So now I have completely removed the conjunctiva all around the white of the eye. This is the so-called white of the eye, is the sclera, and we have completely exposed the sclera all around. My instrument has gone under the conjunctiva. This is the subconjunctival space. It is the space between the conjunctiva and the sclera. I'm just separating the conjunctiva from the underlying sclera so that we can see the sclera much more clearly.
This is all for now regarding the conjunctiva and the subconjunctival space. Thank you very much for watching. Have a nice day. Stay tuned for the next video. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal.